On Friday, 15th of May 2015, the National Airports Corporation Ltd conducted a full-scale emergency fire exercise at the Simon Mwansa Kapwepwe International Airport in Ndola, Kapwepwe Province. The International Civil Aviation Organization, ICAO, mandates airports across the globe to carry out a full emergency fire exercise once every 2 years. During a full-scale emergency fire exercise, several indispensable areas are met. Chief among them are training needs, testing the integration and proficiency of emergency response resources, and also measuring the level of preparedness. It is also an opportune time to determine if any serious gaps exist in the emergency plan. Full-scale emergency fire exercise differ in scenario and execution for obvious reasons. What was the scenario of the 2015 full-scale emergency fire exercise?
The flight was coming in from Johannesburg into Ndola, and it was an ATR-42 with 12 souls on board, 2 crew and 10 passengers.
But why is it very important to know that the rescue operation is functional and that the stakeholders understand this regulatory instrument?
Today's exercise is called the full-scale emergency exercise. And this is an exercise by which we test our preparedness for aviation-related emergencies. And it's a requirement by the International Civil Aviation Organization that at intervals not more than 2 years, we test our preparedness. This exercise cuts across. It's a collaborative effort in that all the other support agencies who have resources to assist in case of an emergency have to come through, and we see how they respond. Conversely, even at site, we have to test the procedures, if the respondents follow procedures.
The Simon Mwansa Kapwepwe International Airport is equipped with state-of-the-art fire tenders with a robust and competent personnel.
These firefighting machines are the most latest that the government has just acquired. They are the code, the E1s. They are supplied by Avion of America. One which is the fire tool, the capacity is 12,000 liters of water, 1,504 liters of foam. The other one which you saw written fire 3 is the medium tender. It is 6,000 liters of water and 777 liters of foam.
With regard to our fire cover, we are indeed at Cat 7, meaning that we are able to handle a big aircraft up to the size of probably an MD-11, which is the biggest aircraft which can land here.
Simon Mwansa Kapwepwe International Airport has in place a detailed plan outlining the process of dealing with the emergency at the airport. The airport manager, Mr. Joseph Mumbi, explains some of the situations that can call for an emergency at an airport.
This is an exercise by which we test our preparedness for aviation-related emergencies, which could be an air crash on airport, air crash off airport, or hazardous material spillage. It could be medical emergency where there is an outbreak of communicable diseases on passengers arriving.
When the fire alarm is sounded, all systems go. When the firefighting and rescue services engage in a life-saving mission, The control tower remains busy notifying responding agencies and other concerned stakeholders about the emergency. Without compromise, it is a requirement to provide an effective coordinated response within 3 minutes of the plane crash should it occur within the airport premises. Why is this so?
Life is priority number one, and we expect that some of the people that we are going to rescue are right in the fuselage, and where the fire is, there could be people there, and they must put off the fire to rescue the people that are in the fuselage.
Upon reaching the crash site, it is expected of the incident commander to guide the driver of the fire tender where to park in order to position his team better to achieve positive results when the initial attack of the fire commences.
Keep on going. Two plus 10 packs on board, fuel engines, 1 hour, 30 minutes. Confirm message copied.
Next to two copies.
In an emergency, one should expect anything. An air crash can happen at night, in the rain, or in a storm. Therefore, preparation for such an accident, and indeed any weather condition, is a must for all responding agencies. When one comes up close with a fire and consider its devastating impact on life and property, one would appreciate why the International Civil Aviation Organization mandates aerodrome operators to effectively plan for emergencies that are caused or may affect aircraft operations. Even though second-hand tires and 80 liters of used oil made the fire for this emergency, the approach to fighting the fire is a real-life battle. These robust firefighters know very well that fire destroys property, fire eats up investment and capital, fire is a monster capable of consuming human life to ashes. The incident commander is also duty-bound to immediately set up a command post where all the responding agencies like the police and medical personnel report to plan and ensure that the rescue operation grows steadily into one functional winning team. Rescue operations are done alongside the initial attack of the fire.
Help! Help!
The search for air crash victims begins within the vicinity of the air crash site, spreading outward to comb the area until all victims are accounted for. That is, those alive and those that unfortunately perish in the accident.
Stretcher! Stretcher!
Additionally, the incident commander sets up the collection area or a triage where medical personnel sort out casualties according to their immediate medical care and needs.
Under medical, our role there is to what we call triaging. Triaging is where you assess the conditions of patients and you tag them. You know, there will be color coding, like those that are given green, then you know they are okay. So when people come, the health personnel come, they look at the tags. If one has got a red tag, it means it's emergency. They have to quickly rush them to the hospital. Then if it's black, then that person is dead. So you don't look at those. So you concentrate on those with the red tags.
The full-scale emergency fire exercise is always complemented by local actors who play different roles depicting plane crash victims. This is the fifth time Komolatu Media is involved in emergency drill by designing the fire and providing drama services. The organization commends the National Airports Corporation for this unique yet developmental partnership.
Ben, call me Ben. My wife, where is she now? Age me, I'm 45. 45, turning
50. Actors who take up a given role are directed to sustain their respective characters from start to finish. And while in action, safety is top priority.
Don't worry. No, please help us.